This is a family recipe, all of them are. We make everything fresh, so we start really early, just preparing what we need. Well, when they see the restaurant, they think it's a chain restaurant and not like a mom and pop. So they're thinking, oh, it's probably really Americanized. Latin people are very strict when it comes to their food. You know, if it's too Americanized, they're like, nah, this is not your grandma's type of food. More of a homey feel and not just like a fast food place. My name is Erica.
I'm John.
We're the owners of Califa's. Actually, we started in our backyard. I ended up getting on a group chat for the subdivision, and I was like, hey, neighbors, what do you think of me, you know, cooking some tacos and you guys trying it out? You know, it's just something I have in the back of my mind, and I just want to see what you guys think. So one of our popular dishes is the birria tacos, so that's what we'll be showing you today from beginning to end. So basically I chop up the meat, then since I have this guajillo prepped, I'm gonna go ahead and just throw it in. Your birria has to be red. You know, a lot of places are known as red tacos. I was taught to cook it like very slow for about eight to 10 hours. So what we're prepping today most likely will be served tomorrow, if not for dinner. We take out all the fat, and then it has a little bit of broth there, and that's where we dip our tacos, and that's how they become red. So this is different from deep frying. You know, you actually cook it in the flat top. You are using the grease from the broth, but it takes a little bit more time and it's not as crispy as when you deep fry it. So we add the cheese and then we add the meat. I'm grabbing some of the consomme, which is basically the broth from the beef, and this is what you're gonna be dipping your tacos in. Traditional tacos were soft tacos, and then later on it was introduced with cheese and make them crispy like that. This style was reintroduced, honestly, like in Tijuana, you know, in Guadalajara, but the difference is just, you see, you could hear it, like look at the juice just come out in it. It's just, it makes it, I don't know, just very different. What makes this unique, I feel that here there's a lot of Tex-Mex, different types of Latin food. If you go to California, whatever you want, you'll find over there. So I'm trying to bring here a little bit of a California Latin style food with the ingredients and the traditions that my family has.
Some of our dishes, like the San Diego burrito, it brings in a lot of people who are originally from South Carolina, stationed in San Diego. They were coming in here saying, do you guys really put the fries in your burrito? And I'm like, yes.
The story is basically the surfers from San Diego wanted something hearty, you know, for them to be full while they're surfing all day. So they asked a restaurant years ago, you know, can you make me a burrito, but instead of rice and beans, for it to have French fries and, you know, like the pico and the carne asada. And that's how this San Diego burrito is made. Califa's has allowed us to connect with the Latin community in Greenville. It's great to have that support. And then of course, the ones that are moving into Greenville, you know, out of state, they always compliment us and they're like, oh, this is a taste of home. You know, it reminds us of, you know, the West Coast or wherever they're from. So it's nice to hear that. I don't really see this as, oh, it's a restaurant, I'm waiting for a customer to come in. I'm honestly, I guess, because my passion is cooking, Like every time I see somebody come in, it's like, you're my family. Come in. Here, let me give you a dish. Is it nice and warm? Do you like it? Do you want anything else? Like have that conversation, that one-on-one, and not just, oh, you're a number, you know? It's like, if you come in, oh, hey, how you doing today? How's it going? Oh, I remember, you know?